In this special episode of the AI Show Build Edition, we hear from Neha Rajput, product manager on the Microsoft QnA team. Neha will show us what's new at Build for QnA Maker, along with some awesome demos to boot, think rich editing, new features, etc. Make sure you tune in.
Everyone, this is Neha Rajput. I'm a product manager in QnA Maker. I own the relevance and fundamental part of QnA Maker.
In Build 2020, I want to talk about everything new that is coming up in QnA Maker. This time, we really focused on enhancing the overall authoring experience of the developers. So I'll talk about all the new features that are going live in Build, and then I'll also show you quick demos of these cool features. Then I'll talk about how QnA Maker is being used extensively in situations like these to provide information to people about COVID-19. After that, we'll give you a quick sneak peek of what we have available in private preview, which is QnA Maker V2. So there are basically two new features that are going live in Build. First is rich text authoring and second is role-based access control. Now let's check out each of these in detail. Now, this has been a long-awaited feature by our customer. I remember having calls with different customers and MVPs and talking about if they have any pain point or any other feedback for the product. And as a feedback, I used to get it quite a number of times like, hey, can you improve the authoring experience? Or it's a bit difficult to write it in a specific markdown language. We took that feedback quite seriously and are now offering what you see is what you get kind of experience to the customer. What I mean here is, now you can improvise your answers in the knowledge base present in the QnA Maker portal with different editing styles, like you can add bold, italics, unordered list, ordered list, and several other features. Now let me show you a quick demo of how you can do rich text authoring. You need to go to your QnA Maker portal and open your knowledge base. So for example, this is my knowledge base where I was trying rich text authoring, and this is my answer. If I click on the answer, I can see a lot of options available in the toolbar. I can toggle it to markdown view. I can toggle back. I can add bold. So this is in bold. I can add italics. I can do strike through. I can add a numbered list. I can add bulleted list. You can also do different type of headings over here. For example, this rich text authoring, this is of type heading 1. Then this is of type paragraph. So you can choose different font as per your scenario. You can add hyperlinks. So the moment I click on this hyperlink, it shows me the link that I have used. You can quickly edit the link from here, or you can remove the hyperlink. You can also render images over here. So if I click on image, it shows me the alternate text that I have provided for the image, also the link for the image. You can quickly edit the link from here, or you can cancel it. So if I click on these three dots, it shows me more options for adding the hyperlink, for adding more emojis. You can undo and redo and do several other things that are provided over here. Let me add one more QnA pair. So for example, try out the feature. Enter the answer. So it says, hey, let me make it a bold, and then I can add list like 1, 2, and 3. So this is how easy it becomes using the rich text authoring, because you can actually visualize and write the text in the manner you want without using a specific markdown. So what I did is I went ahead and I published it on a Teams channel and I created a bot out of it. So let me show you that bot. So this is the bot that I created. I've already been chatting with it. So for example, I asked more headings. So it replied me with the best suitable answer that was present in the knowledge base. Then I asked capabilities of rich text authoring. Then it shows me the exact answer that we have created in the knowledge base. So this is how easy it becomes using the rich text authoring experience to create an answer from scratch, because you can add all the capabilities that are present over there. Now let's talk about another feature that is going GA in Build. This feature again has been asked by a lot of customers. So if you have several content authors to create the data, what happened till now is you need to share the access to the service to everyone with the cognitive service user role, which means they get all the access. That is, they can not only create or update a knowledge base, but they can also go ahead and publish the knowledge base. To control this, some customers created a workaround. For example, I know some customers who used to create two services, one test and one prod. And where in the test they add all the content authors, where they can iteratively improve the quality of the knowledge base by adding or updating QnA pairs and other information. As knowledge base editing is an iterative process, and once the supervisor or the owner is satisfied with the quality of the knowledge base, they go ahead and export it to the prod service. Then there are a few customers who allow content authors to create content in Excel sheets, and once they think that the content is ready for production, they import it in the QnA Maker service. Now going ahead, with this feature, we are providing those capabilities within the service by adding two new roles, editor role and reader role, apart from the existing cognitive service user role, which is the one having all the permissions. You can think of editor role as the role that most of the content authors will get, as they will be allowed to create, update, test, and other functionalities apart from publishing the KB. Reader role is the one with the minimum access. Think of someone like a supervisor or a quality tester who will get this permission, as they can only read and test the service. Now, publisher is the existing role who is the one with all the permission, including publishing the knowledge base and deleting the knowledge base. Now, one thing to keep in mind is this is a service level setting. Now, let me show you how can you provide access to different people or share your service with different people with different roles assigned to them. So all you need to do is go to your Azure portal and here open your QnA Maker resource. For example, this admin QnA bot, you can see the API type is QnA Maker. So this is a QnA Maker resource. Then go to access control. Here, if you click on this role sub tab, you can see there's a cognitive service user role, which is the existing role that you get. And then there are two more roles, that is cognitive service QnA Maker reader, cognitive services QnA Maker editor. Now go to check access, click on add a role assignment. Select the type of role you want to give access with. So for this demo, I'll select reader. And then add the ID of the person you want to give access to. And then just click on save, and that person will be provided the access with the role that you have selected. Now let me show you how each of these roles is different from the other one. For this, I have created three different services, one specific to each role. First one is with the cognitive service user role. So let me show you that. So here for this knowledge base, I have the role of cognitive service user. So here you can see, so I can add QnA pair, I can add follow prompts, I can add alternative phrasing, I can publish the knowledge base, I can actually do everything. So this is like the current existing role, where as a content author, I get access to almost everything that is allowed to do on a knowledge base. Now let me show you how it is different from the editor role. So here with the service for this knowledge base, I have the role of editor. So here you can see I can add QnA pair, I can add follow prompts, I can add alternative phrasing, I can do almost everything except publishing the knowledge base. So if I go and hover over the publish button, it shows this role does not have the permission for this action. That means as an editor, I can create, test, update the knowledge base, but all I cannot do is publishing the knowledge base. Now let me show you how it's different from the reader role. So this is the third service with the reader role access. So here, as you can see, there are a lot of options that are not available. For example, I cannot add a QnA pair. There's nothing over here. I cannot add follow prompts. I cannot add alternate phrasing. I cannot even save and train it. So if I go and hover over there, it says this role does not have the permission for this action. I cannot even publish it, though I cannot publish as an editor also, but reader has the minimum access. So you cannot do anything except reading the knowledge base and testing it. Going ahead, let's see how QnA Maker is being used to spread useful information among people about COVID-19. In a situation like this, where the whole world together is fighting against a common enemy, COVID-19, Microsoft is providing several out-of-box solutions with healthcare bot template, which enables customer to quickly create a bot in no time. In addition, we have open source technology and template for developers to create their own solutions. Also, several third party are creating their own customer support solution on top of Microsoft technology stack. We are glad that QnA Maker is able to contribute to the cause, as it's being used extensively across the globe to provide general information to the people, like what we should take care of, common symptoms, and how we can protect ourselves efficiently. One such example is self-checker bot currently hosted on CDC website. Another example is a conversational chatbot hosted on Providence Healthcare website, where when you ask questions, the bot is actually looking at QnA Maker database and responding with the best answer for the query. In India too, several state governments are building general awareness bot which answers frequently asked questions about COVID-19. One such example is Cova bot. I will show you shortly how it spread awareness among people. Because of this, we have seen a huge spike in QnA Maker traffic. Our engineering team is working dedicatedly to help different customers to manage support tickets and maintain SLA. It makes us proud that QnA Maker is able to help people in these difficult times. Now let's jump to the demo of Cova chatbot that has been created by one of the state government in India, Punjab. So this is the Cova chatbot. As you can see, there's a welcome message with two options like health check and FAQ. Now if I click on FAQ, it shows me different options. So I go ahead and click on what is coronavirus. It shows me the answer for the same. Now if I again select FAQ, and this time if I opt for helpline number, it shows me the helpline number. Now if I select the FAQ again, and this time if I select others, then I can type my customized questions. For example, now I'll ask the bot, should I continue to wear a mask? So all these answers that are coming from the bot are actually powered by QnA Maker. So as you can see, now I've typed the question and I got the answer for the same. As it requires really low effort and time to create a bot using QnA Maker, it is the reason that different government and healthcare centers are creating general awareness through FAQ bots built over QnA Maker product. It's the time to give you a quick sneak peek in what we have to offer in private preview right now, which is QnA Maker V2. Today, QnA Maker has a self-hosted architecture where customers are responsible for managing their resources in their own subscription. So whenever a customer onboard to QnA Maker, they have to pay and manage App Services, Azure Search Service, and QnA Maker service separately. With this service model, which is currently in private preview, customer does not need to handle this. They can scale up and down in a seamless manner. They just need to create one QnA Maker resource and everything else will be handled by us behind the scenes. Right now, as it's in private preview, hence the resource is free. As of now, QnA Maker management layer is only present in West US, though we don't store any data over there, it's just for the management APIs. But with this service model, we are offering end-to-end support in other regions as well. For example, it is completely available in North Europe in private preview. Going forward, we are planning to add other regions as well. Now, QnA Maker V2 uses state-of-art deep learned ranking model to enhance the relevance. Now, currently QnA Maker's extraction breaks the data into QnA pairs, which could sometimes contain large passages as the answer. Now, here we are using machine reading comprehensions for precise answer, which will return the precise answer span text as an answer to the query. Let me show you how. So here on the left, you can see the current experience where we are returning the exact passage that is stored in QnA Maker as an answer. Whereas with MRC capability, you can see the precise answer span is shown as an answer. So for example, how much time does it take to charge the surface? all we are returning with machine reading comprehension is 2 to 4 hours. Isn't it awesome? Now, if you're excited to try out all these cool features that come along with QnA Maker V2, here's the link to the form where you can get your subscription whitelisted. Just click on this link, https://aka.ms/QnA Maker V2 signup, and we'll go ahead and whitelist your subscription. This is all from QnA Maker. I hope you liked it. Signing off. Have a great day. Thank you.